It's refreshing to get out, nice day, not to be locked up.
It's a late Thursday morning here in Atlanta's English Avenue in an area known as The Bluff. Residents here are used to seeing scenes like this. Abandoned homes, trash on the street, debris covering the sidewalks. But thanks to the Love Our City campaign, Paynes Avenue is getting cleaned up.
We do everything from tire removal to graffiti removal to, as you see behind me, cleaning clothes and houses, but as well as sidewalks, things that ordinarily aren't touched on a daily basis.
Inmates from the Department of Corrections are brought out to areas like this to clean up the trash, clear the sidewalks, and secure vacant homes against squatters and wild animals.
One of the mayor's goals is creating a safer city, creating a safer environment for those that live around it.
The Love Our City campaign grew out of the Clean and Close program, which partners corrections with code enforcement to clean up abandoned properties. For the Love Our City campaign, residents make requests to have an area cleaned up. The department received 144 of these requests in February alone.
And it also gives the detainees an opportunity to get out of being confined for the day, and hopefully put us in a position when they get back that they just want to take a shower, feel they've done some good in the community.
The inmates are low-level offenders, people who have broken city ordinances like disorderly conduct. And while we can't show you their faces, these guys were more than happy to be working outside. Chief Labatt says one inmate on a previous detail wanted to show off his community service.
And he wanted to know it was okay to post on his Facebook when he got out that he actually was involved over in the West End community planting trees.
Clean and Close and the Love Our City campaign have already saved the city $2 million. But for Chief Labatt, his guards, and the inmates, uplifting these neighborhoods is its own reward.
Anything we can do to bring value back, create a safer environment with respect to kids walking past different houses, going to school, going back and forth to the bus stop, we want to be able to do it.
For Atlanta Now, I'm Troy Danicus.